Hello, and welcome to another episode of Exotic Conversations with Arnie Carmichael. I'm your host, Arnie Carmichael. I don't know if we touched on this before, but I am doing the No Shave November, so hence we have this beautiful, lovely lack of locks on my head and a beautiful beard on my face. So, today we have Leah Bothamley, who is the president of Buzz Marketing, professional snowboarder, economist, astronomist, and a pseudo-archaeologist. It's going to be marvelous. Leah Bothamley of Buzz Marketing, El Presidente, correct?
Presidente. Absolutely, that's me.
Is that what they use? Do they use Spanish?
No, just American. Totally president all the way.
Indeed, the president. So, Buzz Marketing, does it focus more on businesses or organizations?
We focus on businesses, primarily. We don't do too much with organizations.
Because it's a straight-up marketing profitability. You're taking the company, you're shaping its face, you're putting the Coke logo on there, and that's a whole deal.
Absolutely.
Correct?
Yep. Entire package.
They come in, and they say, we're going to sell you Wonder Bars. And then you say, well, Wonder Bars Incorporated, TM. Boom. You get that going. You make the production models. You get the scans and the building models and the plans with the graphs, and it's a whole thing, and then boom, they're on the map, they're selling things, they're setting up shops in Tokyo and in Argentina. This was a horrible little map thing
Argentina,
that I just made.
Yeah, down here.
Yeah, because we got over here and then...
Yeah, we come down into South America and then go over into Argentina.
Yes, because I was over here in Tokyo and then I just said... There's a lot of children that watch this show, and they're going to get the complete wrong idea from my graphic overrepresentations of poorly knowledged geography sentence words.
We're not all geologists.
It's true. Nobody is. So, who could join it? Is it specifically for marketing majors, or are we talking like the whole campus, open to everybody?
Entire campus. Welcome to join. Anybody.
You don't even have to have a... No business background.
No, right? You don't have to. And in fact, you know, it's kind of preferable. I want fresh ideas in my organization.
It's true. So. Bringing it right in. You're taking the hamburger and you're bringing that up and you're making meatloaf out of these students.
Yep, selling ketchup.
I feel like I'm spitting a lot today and I'm not really sure what that's all about. I flossed the other day. That might be part of it.
Yeah, now you've got these open gapes that just liquid can
spew
out.
Yeah, I think it's right here. I remember being at the pool as a child and people would shoot the water out of the gaps.
Yeah.
I feel like that's kind of what's going on. It's weirding me out a little bit. So you could even bring, like, you could have a psychology student or major. Mm-hmm. Yes, psychology major. That's what they call them here at
majors.
College. You could have a psychology major, and he's going to bring in the psyops. He's going to be like, subliminal advertising.
Subliminal advertising. We can bring in biologists who can show us, you know, ways to grow advertising out of plants.
Exactly. Yes. I've seen that. I've seen the advertising in the plants.
Yep.
I'm pretty sure it was a computer graphic, but still, the idea is there, the manpower.
Attaching cookies to plants is brilliant.
And then they manipulate it. They do the thing with the deal. Ah, genes. That's the word I was thinking of. They manipulate the genes, so you're growing different letters in the leaves of the plants.
Different colors.
And then you
have
Coca-Cola spelt out with leaves on a tree.
Oh my gosh, we would be millionaires.
Exactly.
Success.
As long as you got like a part of that Coca-Cola money. I mean, otherwise you're just going to have a huge lawsuit.
Small royalty.
Mm-hmm. Like 3%. 3% of the Coca-Cola proceed is.
I would take 0.03%. That would be a huge chunk of change from Coke.
All right, where are we? Here we are. We said who it's opened up to, and what does the organization offer for members then? Because I remember talking about how there were was it scholarships?
Scholarships is part of it. We offer a wide range of benefits. It starts really with getting professional experience, knowledge where you don't have it. And then from there, it's moving on to real actual projects that we do for businesses, we do for nonprofit organizations. From there, that's where we get our success funneled into our organization. Then once we establish our reputation, success, what we offer to individual members are scholarships, internships, being published, a lot of different avenues.
It's good stuff. Yeah. Good stuff. Boom. See? Now we're moving down the line. A lot of times it's just all about me drawing random things on the paper.
Do you draw stick figures?
Never really stick figures. It's just kind of a lot of circles and X's. X's and O's, if you will. I feel like it's some sort of subliminal possible love interest thing that I have with my script. I'm just
take
X's
her
and O's.
Home.
That isn't even a part of a question. That's just the video shot directions and completely superfluous to this. So, how long have you been the president of Buzz Marketing?
Total of 4 years. I was actually elected twice. I served my first 2 years as the founding president. I took about a year off to really focus on my studies last year, and then
find
my direction. I love marketing, but I needed to nail down snowboarding last year. So
corporate retreat.
Yes, absolutely. Get some structure back into my life, some fun time. And then I came back. I was asked to head up the organization again this year, and I accepted. So
awesome. So you're just like Obama. You're coming in for a second term.
Second term.
You're going to build it back up. You're going to take your progress, and you're going to take it to the next level.
Yes. The next,
right.
The higher level.
Let's
higher
hold on
education.
A sec. Do you want to get out?
Yes.
Okay. There was a maintenance man in here, and he's taking photographs
of things.
I really hope we're still recording, because I feel like we could leave that in there. Yes, we are still recording. Good to know. See, BHSU here in the video department, we take care. We're always on the cutting edge. We're striving to move forward, get things going in the right direction, chain link, steps and steps and steps.
Beam me up, Scotty.
It's true. Even though we still record on videotapes.
Yeah.
Yep. So, what am I doing here?
Let's
we got see. That. We got the presidency covered. Incumbents,
yep.
Obama,
rocking
the streets.
It out. Pushing up there.
Last time I threw a piece of paper from the script, I actually nailed myself in the eye. It was god awful. There we go. That's a good one.
Nice.
That was nice. It was a
smooth.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So what kind of projects are you guys currently working on then?
Currently we're focusing on a single project. It is a large project. It's working with DC Faber and his company, Faber Synergies. What we're doing is we're going to take the idea of helping veterans around this time of year, set up an event towards March. Draw 200 to 500 people and have a good time.
That's great.
Mm-hmm.
That's great. And you're incorporating the 842nd who recently came home, correct?
Yes, absolutely. Actually, that's our focus with these men and women coming home. We want to give them about 4 to 5 months to really settle in, and then we want to try to reach out to them and see what we can do for them.
Excellent. Reintegration. It's a big deal.
Yes.
Yep. Nailed that. Oh! No, we didn't nail that. I was just drawing pictures on here again. Re-accreditation, that's a big thing for Buzz Marketing right now, correct?
Yes,
and the
is.
Business school of BHSU.
Yeah, yep, the College of Business from Black Hill State University. What AACSB is it's the association to advance.
Oh, it's ACSB.
It's AACSB.
Okay,
yeah.
Because I had it as bean.
Oh,
like,
it's bean?
Like a bean you eat.
No, not quite. The AA is the Association to Advance Collegiate Schools of Business.
Mm.
Black Hill State University, the College of Business specifically, has been involved in trying to receive this accreditation for about 6 years. 2 years ago, Buzz Marketing wrote a marketing plan for the College of Business to help them and succeed with getting this accreditation. A lot of our strategies have been implemented. 3 deans representing AACSB were on our campus in October. They audited our classes, they audited everything, and they came back with their results that were good enough to get accreditation, and it should happen within the year.
Nice. So that's nationwide, and you're putting BH on the map with, like, the huge
Harvard,
Ivy League guys.
Yes. And it's not just nationwide. It's actually an international organization. So out of all the business schools in the world, only 10% or less have this accreditation.
Mm.
So receiving this accreditation is huge. It's just really huge.
That is. That's nuts.
Mm-hmm.
I wish I could name off any business schools from foreign countries, but I cannot.
Oh, really? You can't think of any? One in England?
It's odd because usually my hobnobbing in special skills, and not hobnobbing, actually hobbies. My hobbies are looking up statistical facts about international education facilities.
Yeah, you should look it up. There's great business schools in Australia, in the UK, of course.
Like Cambridge.
Yeah, there you go.
England. Boom! Nailed it.
Nailed it.
Ha!
They have a school of business.
I thought that said lube. Awkward.
We will be known as the Harvard of the Midwest. That is huge.
That sounds pretty sweet, actually.
Yeah. Yeah. I want to go to Harvard. Everyone wants to go to Harvard. Just not pay for it.
Mm-hmm. Do you think we're going to get accents with that, too? Like, with the accreditation, we're going to get Harvard, Boston.
I'm going to get
Boston,
the snooty.
New York.
Snootiness.
Looking down on our noses, people.
No, I don't think that'll happen. We're much too Midwest for that.
It's true.
Yeah.
We're way too nice.
We're solid.
Mm-hmm. Which is weird because Midwestern philosophy doesn't actually equate to business philosophy in my mind.
No.
Because business is very cutthroat, I feel like. I've seen a lot of movies with Ben Affleck where he's playing a businessman and he's very angry all the time. And then there's
stressed.
The younger guy with the ulcer and he's selling stocks, Pursuit of Happiness. Will Smith, very, very cranky in that movie. But, I mean, he was also living in a subway station, so that makes sense
to
me. In the bathroom with his child. Yep. I would be cranky, too, if I had to share a room with a kid.
Business world, how many businesses can you move? Out here, how many cows can you brand?
Mm-hmm.
A little bit different pressure.
Oh, branding. Branding. So, when does your... Is it organization?
Yep.
It's not
club. We're considered an organization.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Okay. When does your organization meet?
We meet every Mondays. We're in the Trump conference room, and that's in the student union, and we meet from 3:30 to 4:30.
Great. Get some people from my show, get the marketing going for this bad boy.
You should. That's what we do. That's what we're here for. So please come in.
Yeah. Let's send somebody over there, one of my interns.
Oh, the interns.
I don't actually have interns.
Oh,
wish I did.
Gopher.
Wish I did. I've only had one person go get me coffee on the show, and that was a person who needed hours for a class, so it didn't even count. I was just like, will you do this? She's like, well, where's your money at? And I was like, here you go. I'm like,
oh, you had to pay for it too, huh?
Yeah, I had to pay for my own coffee. The only real thing is that I didn't go physically get it myself, so that made me feel a little Hollywood.
Did you tip her, or was it just for credits?
No. I like to, have you seen The Life Aquatic with Steve Zissou?
Yeah.
Where he has the unpaid interns?
Yeah.
I could really go for something like that.
Most interns are unpaid.
Mm. You know,
I've been lucky. My internships have been paid through Buzz Marketing.
Yeah, we were talking about that with the Google Gateway.
Close, Microsoft.
Silicon Valley.
Yeah.
Gateway and Microsoft are the same, aren't they?
No.
Really?
No.
Wow.
It's Gateway, and there's Microsoft.
I've been wrong for years.
Yeah.
I thought they were the exact same thing.
Oh, it's like...
Or at least like a division.
Hewlett Packard and Apple are the same thing. No.
Are they?
No.
Okay.
No way.
Oh, boy.
Two different...
I need to make
both
some phone
giants,
calls later.
But two different giants, yeah.
Is Gateway still a giant, or have they kind of...
Gateway is just a market challenger. They're not really.
Just what?
A market challenger.
Oh.
Somebody who doesn't have large market share, but did at one point in time and is still maintaining a decent competitive position. But.
Nice. I feel like I've just mixed up
jargon.
All sorts of advertisements for like the last 6 years of my life.
Yeah. I think we've thrown out a good 20 brands out there so far.
It's true. I think the more we can get out there, the better. People are just going to be like, meh. Or we're going to get sued. Either way.
Say, hey, I branded you. I deserve your royalties.
Mm-hmm. I think that should be fair because obviously my fan base is enormous.
Enormous. Yep. Do you have a Twitter, a Facebook, social media campaign? Good. You need it.
I actually have a super PAC.
A super PAC. Dig, are you getting large donations every week?
No.
You need to sell stuff. You got to sell the college package. That's what works.
We'll get onto that
in a bit,
I think. Not right. A minute. It's kind of a thing. But there we go. I can come to you guys and I could expand my fan base, you know, from the 5 to maybe 6 people to watch it then.
Yep.
And then
I can get 200 people to like you in less than 10 days.
Really?
Yes. Mhm.
That does sound like something I need to do.
Popularity in an instant.
Mhm. And you guys have a website, correct? Which is linked through BHSU?
It's a webpage on BHSU's website. So when you look up clubs and organizations, you can just type in Buzz Marketing. It'll pull us up, or you can just go look for a list of organizations. Our name is hyperlinked to a page that will give you all the information about where you meet, who our president is, how you can contact me.
Good deal. So you just got all your information on the interwebs.
We're linked. We're linked in.
LinkedIn, are you on that thing?
Yes.
That's a business thing.
It is.
Correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, everybody actually should have a LinkedIn. It's an amazing, amazing tool. I mean, I've known students who've gotten a job and quit halfway through their degree because they've gotten jobs that they were expecting to get.
Because they were LinkedIn, correct?
Because they were putting all their projects, putting all their recommendations right there. So an employer didn't have to receive your resume. They can just go out, keyword search for a specific talent. You come up, they look at you. As long as you have the experience, you're hired. Doesn't matter if you graduate.
That's really something.
We actually, our vice president of Buzz Marketing just went through that. He has one more semester left, and he left school because he got a good job.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah.
I believe it was the great Jay-Z who said, I'm not a businessman, I'm a business man.
Business, I think.
Business?
I'm the business man.
Like biznasty? You think he kind of rolls that in?
I think that's part of his jargon. The biz nasty, because it is nasty.
All right. Well, so I know you really wanted to touch on the X Games. So let's get into that. How does the branding and the X Games correlate together?
You know, I hope to work in the snowboard industry. And by doing that, I will be branding probably many things snowboard. X Games, Annan Goggles, Burton, the whole nine. So
it's like Shaun White and the Stride Gum. Do you have your gum?
No, I will not have my own products. I will be helping other athletes receive theirs.
So you're going to create the next Shaun White gum?
Yes.
That's great.
I'm going to market the next Shaun White and ride next to him because I'm that good. But
maybe poke him, be like, show him some stuff.
Maybe.
That's what I would do, is I would get someone who is completely famous and then be that person in the background who's like, I taught him everything.
Everything he knows came right from here. You know what I have noticed? There are some people who excel at certain parts of snowboarding and others that excel in a totally different area. You always have something to learn from somebody who's probably not as good as doing the double cork, but somebody who can ride steep and deep might not be your thing. You can learn from them.
That's some jargon, isn't it?
It is. Steep and deep. It is.
Shredding the gnar.
Yeah.
That's good stuff.
Jumping the guinea. That's my own. Jump in the guinea. We have this little barrel up at Terry Peak that looks like a guinea pig from far away. Mm-hmm. So that's what we call it, jump in the guinea.
Nice.
Yeah.
I was at work the other day, because this isn't just my regular job as much as I wish it was, but I was at work the other day and one of my coworkers said people thought Dr. Pepper was crazy when he mixed those 23 flavors.
Oh, yeah.
And I kind of want that to be a catchphrase. I like it a lot.
Didn't they used to call when you mixed all your pop-up together like a zombie or something like that? It was like from the 90s, early 90s.
There was some ridiculous name for it. I remember that, but I don't. It's not clicking.
Yeah, you might have to be 30.
It's like a cocktail, something maybe. I don't even know what kids do these days. There it is!
Yes, suicide.
From the booth.
From the booth. That's why he's your wingman.
It's the first time actual information has come out of that booth that was usable. No offense to my crew. They're up there.
Us are canceling you right now.
I have a staff of 80 people that work 24/7.
I bet.
I'm kind of a taskmaster. It's like a Chinese sweatshop around here sometimes.
So you are the business, man.
It's true.
All right.
Sometimes. Jay-Z actually said that about me. So, snowboarding, we're nailing it.
Yep, not an ex-gamer, but I
not
am a professional.
Yet.
It could happen. It could happen.
But you have the, you're ready.
I'm skilled.
You're ready to make
that skill,
next step.
But I don't have the desire to compete like that. I do plan on entering the national circuit for racing, snowboard cross. That's probably as tricky as I'll get. But.
Mm-hmm. Is that like with the, I know skiers have the different flags, and then Better Off Dead with the K-12.
Slalom type, is that what you're talking about?
Yes, that's probably the word I was describing.
Yep, slalom is awesome. I taught two young men last year how to race the slalom on the snowboard. It's interesting, they actually set up the poles differently than they do for skis.
Is it more difficult, would you say, than skiing, or just kind of a...
I've done it with both, so I would have to say that snowboarding is a little bit more difficult to learn those technical carves, turns that you need.
Mm-hmm.
Retraction turns on the slalom are key.
definitely.
So when you're on a skis, you're just rocking, you're just a fanny wagger. You're going back and forth between the poles. When you're a snowboarder, you're doing this number.
So you're in the business. You're
getting
after
business.
It. You're shredding the kill space and cutting up the V-boards with the downward cake spirals.
Yep. One wrong move and you're toast.
It's true. See, I learned all of that jargon from that snowboarding game, SX Tricky.
Yeah, SSX?
Yes.
Yep.
That's the one.
Love it.
But I don't have like the updated versions. I just have a PlayStation, so it's
regular
really old, outdated, early jargon.
No, that's really awesome, though. I mean, it all works. Getting tricky.
Good to know.
Yep.
And maybe eventually, if I ever go snowboarding, they'll see that and they'll be like, this guy's old school. talking about cutting the cake and whatnot.
Sliding the rail. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. So, going back to the branding, tying in snowboarding, do you think you're ever going to jump with a snowboard from space like that Red Bull commercial that just came out?
Dude, I want to. I would love to. My snowboard, packs on, jump down, free fall, hope the chute opens.
Land on top of Everest.
Ride it. I want to land on the rocks.
Mm.
Yeah.
I don't even know why that's such a big deal.
I don't know either. Wingsuit. You need a wingsuit. Definitely.
Like the with the squirrel?
Yeah. Squirrel. My dream is always to go on my snowboard, jump off a cliff in my squirrel suit, take off.
That'd be amazing.
Extreme.
I'd even want to do that. I think that'd be really something.
I'm jumping out of a helicopter in February.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to do snowboarding then as when you jump out and land?
Yeah, and it's not so much jumping out. You don't want to jump while the helicopter's in air, but, you know, you'll cause it to crash. But you kind of want to just allow your body weight to fall out. I'll be falling about 10 feet, Silverton.
That's legit.
Colorado. I'm stoked. I just got a bunch of gear, avalanche gear. I'm all ready.
Do you have to have a lot more equipment, like different equipment for when you're going to do that?
Yes. Yep. You have to have, I don't even know where to start. All your gear's got to be able to handle extreme conditions just in case something happens and you're up there for a while. You have to have, you should have a beacon. I actually have a transponder, which is a beacon and a transceiver in one. So I can actually, if I'm riding with somebody and they get in trouble, I can search for their signal as well. But you need shovels, ice picks.
All of that hanging off of you?
Yeah, you have a pack on.
You're going to be like Batman.
I'm going to be like Superman. Because Batman travels light. Superman
doesn't have anything.
He doesn't.
He has absolutely no storage compartments available.
He comes with a spaceship, though.
Not when he's like running around doing his thing,
though. It's at his parents' house, though.
He's just straight up
flying.
That's
where all his stuff's at.
He doesn't... This is odd because usually I'm the one who brings up the nerd references. It doesn't ever happen.
I'm a nerd.
It's true.
I will admit it.
Superman doesn't live with his parents. He lives in that crazy ice cave in the middle of nowhere.
I know, but he can get to his parents' house in like under 5 seconds anywhere in the world.
So it's kinda,
anything he needs, he just.
Oh, you're talking about the Kents here on Earth.
Mm.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
He probably has a lot of stuff just stored there. So you're saying in the middle of a fight, Superman runs over to the Kents, comes back.
Gets all energized up.
Rocking and rolling.
Comes back and he's like, all right, let's do this.
Getting all crazy. Well, all right. So I think we got a lot of good information out there. Buzz Marketing meets in the Jacket Legacy Room, correct?
Close. Trump Room.
They meet in the Trump Room, like Donald Trump. Think business, think fun, think you're fired, bad reality television. Which is no way involved with the Buzz Marketing Club, except for this, obviously. But we got
that's awesome.
Trump Legacy Room upstairs in the Union, 3:30 to 4:30 on Mondays every week. Come on down, make a visit. They're going to make you a businessman or woman or business
snowboard,
alien.
Come on down.
Exactly. All the information's on the web. So thank you very much. We're going to go ahead. Cap this thing off here. So, for me, Lando, Greedo, Han, Jabba, Boba Fett, Luke, Leia, other Leia, Star Wars Leia, Ewoks, and everyone else here at Exotic Conversations, we're reminding you to find your wild side, Spearfish. Long time ago, galaxy far, far away. Meow! This beast is
my recital. I think it's very vital to rock
around.
That's right.
On top.
It's tricky. It's the tight.
Here we go.
Say is please me or spend some time and rock a rhyme. I said it's not that